What's going on, guys? This is Aaron with Departures Capital. We're here with William Trainer, CEO of Grande West Transportation. How are you doing today, William?
I'm doing great, thanks.
Yes, excited to have you on. So let's start by talking all about Grande West Transportation and what the company's all about.
Great. Well, thank you. We're a bus manufacturer. We're located just outside of Vancouver, Canada here. We started back in 2008, really developed a small mid-size product, entered into a strategic partnership with the province of BC here, with BC Transit, to develop something that really wasn't in the market to begin with. We've done really well on the Canadian side, and now we're really setting our sights on expanding into the U.S.
Yeah, it's a very exciting market, especially this electric vehicle market. Last week, Grande West provided a big corporate update. Can you tell us more about this, and what was the most significant information that, you know, that we should focus on in that update?
Well, what we're trying to do is bring out to the investment community that, you know, we are an established business. We do have revenue and profitability going forward. You know, the EV space is coming faster and faster, but, you know, until it does, there's still some ongoing business out there. So we wanted to give a corporate update and really let the investor community know that that we have, you know, really over $50 million in orders that we're delivering in Q1 and Q2, along with our normal EV business.
Awesome. So Grande West recently appointed respected industry veteran Manuel Achadina, I hope I said that right, as your chief operating officer. Can you tell us a little bit more about this and why it's so significant?
Sure. Well, actually, Manuel was one of the senior people involved in the strategic partnership that we formed with BC Transit. So we stayed in touch over the years, and we've had an opportunity now to actually bring him into the corporation. He just brings a world of wisdom and support, and his background really sets well to what we're trying to accomplish. You know, we have some pretty major rapid growth coming into the U.S. market, and we just needed to really strengthen our management team, and that's where he comes in and really shines for us.
So with many companies entering the EV space, can you tell us what sets you apart from the competition? You know, I know it's definitely a hot industry right now.
Yeah, well, you know, we took our time and really researched what we wanted to bring to market. And what we brought with our EV, I think really, this is where it sets us apart from the competition. We looked at it and we said, okay, what do we need to do to be very competitive? Well, we need to keep the price very competitive to start with. So we aligned ourselves with the automotive industry components. We chose a BMW battery pack for a supply agreement. We chose BMW because there's over 500,000 battery packs out there in the world today, and they're performing extremely well. But it also allowed us to embed the batteries into the low floor section of the bus. So when you get off and on the vehicle, it's on a low floor, easy access. But by putting the batteries in the floor, we get a very low center of gravity, which gives you a lot more stability in the vehicle. Then one of the other things that we did by trying to stay with the automotive industry, we looked at what was happening with the cars. And you look like a Tesla car. You bring it home at night, you charge it into your standard electricity grid that you have in your residential home, which is a 240 volt single phase power. So we put an onboard charger on ours to allow that that you could charge it in a standard setting. So the garages, the type of customers that we're going after, not only on the public side, but on the private side, can pull this vehicle up and charge it overnight for an overnight charging, or charge it in between their routes. Then one of the other things that I think is really going to set us aside is we tried to make this bus really user-friendly. So we looked at, where is it going to operate? It's going to operate in as a community shuttle in the transit market. It's going to operate in a shuttle bus for airports and universities and just general shuttle operations. So we wanted to keep the GVW under 22,500, and that allowed us to put a hydraulic brake system on the vehicle. Hydraulic brakes makes it very easy for drivers to use it, and they won't need a special commercial license where they needed the air brake system. We looked at what the what the school bus industry was doing. We really followed suit with that, with the hydraulic brakes. So we think we've got, you know, a product by trying to stay with the automotive industry components, which is both in the travel and in the drive motor and in the battery pack and in the battery management system. Stay to that. It was off the shelf, easy, accessible, and considerably better priced than what I think the competition is.
Very interesting. So I know that you guys have plans to go onto the NASDAQ. So let's talk about, you know, what you're most excited about for the company over the next 6 to 12 months. Of course, I'm excited to see you guys trade on the NASDAQ, but I'd love to hear, what's the one thing you're most excited about?
Well, the one thing that I'm excited about is, as I stated earlier, we've done exceptionally well on the Canadian side. So we have about 90% market penetration on the Canadian side for our mid-sized product. But our sales, generally speaking, we're getting 90% of our revenue from Canada. Well, we have to really focus on the U.S. This is where it's getting me excited and what we have coming over the next 6 to 12 months. We're building a factory down in Washington State. We chose Washington because it's a 30-minute drive from our headquarters up here, you know, close to Vancouver. We're in Langley, the Fraser Valley area here in Canada. So by choosing that, it allows us to utilize the engineering staff and a lot of cross-border engineering to keep our price competitive. But the Washington State facility will be the headquarters for our U.S. Initial push into the U.S. But also we've strengthened our sales team, our sales drastically in the U.S. We have aligned ourselves with a company called the ABC Group of Companies. They're just a powerhouse. And they've primarily been in the motor coach industry. So by taking on our product and working with us, and they'll be able to cover pretty much all of the US for us, they have the same customer service philosophies as we do, and they align very well. So, By aligning ourselves with the ABC Group, it just opens the doors for our sales and marketing. They've got a tremendous sales force, over 75 salespeople in the U.S. And for the EV market, we really got to get our sights on California. California has been really leading the charge into, you know, greener vehicles and whatnot. The ABC Group has 3 mega locations in California. We just bid a major contract down there called the CALAC bid, which for mid-sized buses, they're projecting to purchase between 3,000 and 5,000 mid-sized buses in the state of California alone. So we're excited. We got everything's coming together extremely well for us.
Yeah, I'm excited to cover your story, definitely. So what are your thoughts on the current electric vehicle market moving forward into the later part of 2021?
Well, we're seeing a lot more activity in the EV space than we ever did. And, you know, everybody's been COVID-related deliveries. And, you know, 2020, we didn't really see a lot of tenders coming out. There wasn't a lot of bids and new bus purchases coming up. But now 2021, we've seen it just the tap turn on, and everybody's looking at an EV. And like I said, I think we've got a very well-positioned EV for the space. But also, you know, we're looking at the funding operations, or what's available for funding. Here in Canada alone, the federal government has provided a lot of funding for EVs. Just currently, the Trudeau government's looking at putting $3 billion a year into EV buses, and you know, definitely we're positioned extremely well for that capital. And then when you look at the U.S. Through the Biden administration is extremely green. They just had their, you know, $1.9 trillion infrastructure funding coming out. A lot of that portions of that definitely will be directed towards cleaning up the environment with getting diesel buses off the road and putting EV buses on.
Yeah, it's a very exciting time, and I think you guys are well positioned. So where's the best place for investors to find out more information about the company?
On our website, there's a link into the investor relations email, and I think that's probably the best way to reach out. IR info@grandewest.com.
Awesome, William. Well, I'm excited to cover your story. We definitely have a lot more videos on the way, so I appreciate your time and look forward to an update in the future.
Great. Well, thanks so much. Thanks for having me today.
All right, guys, that wraps up the video. Thank you so much for watching. I just wanted to say, if you do support me, the channel, and all these videos, then kindly smash that like button along with hitting the subscribe button and the bell for notifications for future videos. I did also want to say, check the disclaimer down below. This video was sponsored by the company that we are talking about today. So check the disclaimer, full disclosure, and we're out of here. Always remember, guys, Departures Capital is for information, education, and entertainment purposes only. Don't buy or sell a stock because you heard it on here. Buy or sell a stock because you've done your research, you've done your thorough due diligence, and you make your own personal investment decisions for yourself. This video is not financial advice. We'll see you guys in our next video.